Welcome everyone. Hope everyone had a wonderful, wonderful week. This week we read a double parsha, parsha's Vayakol Pekudei, Chazak, Chazak, V'nitchazek. And we read in great, great detail once again about the Mishkan and the Kelim and the Mishkan and the Big Day Kahuna, once again in tremendous, tremendous detail. And the Ramban and many others ask the question, why once again the repetition? We saw this already in Shuma, Tetzaveh, echoes in Kisisa. Once again, Vayakol Pekudei, the Ramban says five times. We have relatively detailed descriptions of the Hakamas HaMishkan. Why so many times? Why the details? And the Ramban writes, as we find by Eliezer, when Eliezer is sent to find a wife for Yitzchak, and once again, a detailed psukim repeating the story. So it's a sign of Chavivus, a sign of Hashem's love for Mishkan, for Sichas and Shavadim, for Jewish people, a sign of love, and that's why the great, great emphasis. But perhaps a little further, and a further idea, and certainly said by many, is there is something that happens, again, in the Seder HaPsukim, in the Seder HaParshios, we read Shuma Tetzaveh, which is the command to go ahead and build the Mishkan, create the Big Day Kahuna. Then Kisisa, and we have a break in the action, and we have the Egel Hazav. Now, Ein Mukta Mukhar Batorah, when exactly this took place, not the point, but in the Seder HaParshios, we have the Egel Hazav. Tremendous sin, where Hashem withdraws his Shechina from the people, and he even has the idea of perhaps destroying Klal Yisrael and starting once anew with Moshe Rabbeinu. And then, Vayakel Pekudei. And in a very real sense, the Torah is telling us, and the Mefarshim explain, that in a very, very real sense, the Hakamas HaMishkan is a tikkun for the Avera of the Egel Hazav. And whereas the Egel Hazav, Vayakel, the Jews gathered together to build the Egel, they contributed the Zahav, silver and gold, to construct the Egel. Now it's going to be once again Vayakel, but now, and distributing and bringing in all the gold and the silver, but now for Avodas Hashem, for Mishkan. And if one reads the Pesukim very carefully in this week's parsha, you'll see a refrain over and over and over again. And that refrain is, Kaser Tzivcha Hashem Elokecha. That the Mishkan is created exactly as was commanded by Hashem to Moshe Rabbeinu. And that's a significant, significant comment, because we were commanded in Truma Tetzaveh. The Egel transpires. The Egel was, according to many Mefarshim, how could they fall to Avodah Zarah? Perhaps it wasn't pure Avodah Zarah, but it was an innovation in Avodah Hashem. Moshe was gone. They felt they needed the intermediary, so they innovated. They said, we need some kind of physical structure that will facilitate our connection to you, Hashem. So let's make an Egel. The foot of the Egel is reminiscent of the foot of the Kiseh HaKavod, of the Shechina. And let us go ahead and make a facsimile of Hashem, something we can connect to Hashem with in a material way. So Hashem understands, yes, this is a need of man. We need physical representations. And Hashem says, yeah, build the Mishkan. The Mishkan will also have gold, will also have beauty, will also have even Kruvim, Simanim of Avodah Zarah, perhaps statues, idols, so to speak. But no, here it's command of Hashem, Kasher Tzivcha Hashem Elokecha, over and over and over again. And that's the fundamental difference between Avodah Zarah, foreign worship, and Avodah Hashem. Was it commanded? Are you doing exactly what Hashem commanded or not? Nadav Navi, bring an Eish Zarah into the Kodesh Kadashim. Wasn't commanded. The Kohen Gadol brings Ketores, he brings Eish, he works in the Kodesh Kadashim, and that's exactly what is commanded. That's the fundamental difference. We live in a world where we're always looking for innovation, chidushim, something new, something special, something to liven up Avodas Hashem. But always be careful, always be wary. Yes, we need chiddush. Man needs chiddush, but be wary. It always has to be within the context and confines of Kasher Tzivcha Hashem Elokecha. A mishkan, a physical representation, 100% can be Avodas Hashem if commanded. The difference between Egel Hazav, Rachman Letzlan, and Mishkan, and Kruvim, might be a very fine, subtle one, but the difference is Kasher Tzivcha Hashem Elokecha. In that sense, once the Mishkan is created perfectly, exactly as Hashem commanded, not bigger, not smaller, not more ornamental, not less, exactly, then once again, the Shechina at the end of our parasha, the last Psukim, the Mishkan is completed, the Shechina once again rests on the Mishkan in this world, and the relationship between Ribbono Shel Olam and Klal Yisrael is once again restored. And that's perhaps the message of these parshios, Truma Tetzaveh, Kisisa Egel Azov, and then Vayakol Pekuda. Yes, the details are critically important, because if it's all done, all those details, Kasher Tzivcha Hashem Elokecha, then indeed we'll be zocheh to have the Shechina rest amongst us. Have a wonderful Shabbos Kodesh.